All right, let's take a look at 3A West to finish it off. I think there's some good matchup down here, too.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah.
This is the one.
I'll give a quick shout out to Northeast Guilford, my alma mater. Back to the playoffs. You know, Coach Bates doing a great job there, but it's a lot of talent here. Kings Mountain being a 10 is one that's pretty crazy. I mean, watching them early.
The way they started early,
And I think what their only two losses are Huss and
Chris.
I mean, again, we're in a situation where you lose the two top-notch programs. Yeah. And that's your reward.
Get rewarded.
Not much better, but Huss having to play Monroe. And, I mean, we played Monroe last year. Monroe's never easy. I don't care what they're down,
they
up,
got too
whatever.
Much speed.
They always have amazing athletes out there.
Yeah, that not is a Knox.
Shiree.
See him firsthand.
I mean, he's got more offers than you can shake a stick at.
I think you're going to see him against Dontavious Nash. I think that'd be a heck of a matchup, right?
No, for sure. That's going to be a good one. I mean,
of course, Catholic is Catholic.
Yeah.
Right, I don't care. Yeah,
doesn't matter.
They're like a snake. Until I see you dead, that's the only way I'm going to trust that.
I'm pretty sure they're motivated for that. You know, they beat Frogview. They want that Husk game.
Oh, remember, they played them last year.
They played last year.
Yeah, but, you know, because of the –
Oh, and the whole move. Extra, yeah.
The whole move
on that too. Yeah. Well, I forgot about the running back, but
the whole move.
Good point.
Yeah,
yeah.
I forgot about that. I think Catholic's like, Arthur, you don't have to feel this. You know, we got something.
I think last year they had to go to Huss too. You already know that area's gonna be rocking. Guest on is gonna be pretty crazy.
You just don't know with this bracket because you know, you see. Hush, you see Catholic making a run. You see Chris making a run.
Right, and we didn't even talk about the ones that we go on 2-3 minutes talking. You don't talk about the one, you know, and that's something that's rare in a bracket. But it shows you, like I said, for me growing up in it, 3A's always been competitive.
And I think Kings Mountain got a good champion because I think Statesville really their only, you know, that Statesville King Mountain game in second round gonna be
the one. Ooh, problem though, you gotta travel to these places. Yeah. You go into AC Reynolds in Asheville. Yeah. Like, well, I think it's Asheville. Like,
you know,
it's gonna be snowing.
That's the advantage AC Reynolds has this time of year, man.
Yeah,
they're
so
used to
funny
that,
thing
man.
About that is, my senior year, we went to AC Reynolds in the second round.
Yeah,
and it was like clear. We were like, oh man, we in this game. We came out game time. Came out little basketball locker room. It was snow. We all ran back.
That's the thing this time of year.
Yeah, and that crowd was crazy. You know, it's wonderful. You know, the Rockets, wherever they are. That's an atmosphere. Like you said, you know, you guys start thinking about that. And that's why I said they should open it up a little bit more and let them travel.
So, Coach, you said you're a Northeast Guilford guy. Parkwood has been a pretty good team out of Union County this year. So, what about?
I've talked to them some. Some of the guys, actually, one of my old high school teammates is still on staff. I mean, they're a run-based offense, which, as I always say, running the ball and playing good defense never gets so old this time of year. Mm-hmm. I think the bigger thing for them is can they complete the deep pass down the field? Having over 2,000 yards rushing, you know, for them, it's making sure they can handle a team. And I always tell them, you know, teams in this area are go through pretty good competition. I mean, you got Marvin Ridge, you know, I said, there's on the Parkwood schedule, Catholic, Weddington. Mm-hmm. I mean, Parkwood's used to playing tough teams.
Coming out of a tough conference, kind of similar to the IMEC.
No, it's a 3A version, I would think. I mean, with all those teams in it, you know, but. He's been talking IMEC. We're going to get him back over there anyway. Some way, shape, or form. But, no, it's you know, so that's going to be the thing for them. Can they step up even though they're at home? Mm-hmm. You know, can they step up to a team that's battle-tested on the road? Because that's not a true 11 seed like what they would expect. Right. So, I wish them best of luck, but it's going to be a tough test.
All right, guys. Great stuff, man. Thank you so much for your time tonight, man. We really appreciate it. Great insights.
Yeah, thank you.